Hey guys, welcome to this week's individual weekly video for the week of June 18th. And I'm so excited because this week is actually a really cool collaboration with a chance for you to win your own tarot deck from Hip Chick Tarot. We have got Maria coming up after my forecast, not only telling you a little bit about her cards and her tarot deck, but also giving each individual sign a little mini reading of what that card applies to for them for the week. So make sure you stay tuned after your forecast to see what Maria has to say for you as well. And make sure you like, comment, share, subscribe my page and Maria's for a chance to grab this tarot deck, which is phenomenal. All right, stay tuned for your forecast. Hey Pisces, this week, the week of June 18th, your ruling planet Neptune is taking a retrograde and it's taking it in your sign. So as you know, you're obviously very used to the Neptunian energy and it can be a very in-between the worlds kind of passive energy, right? But this time, as Neptune goes retrograde, the thing we get is clarity. And because it's happening in your sign, Pisces, the thing you're going to get the most clarity about is you. Right now, there is a Piscean stereotypical tendency kind of quality to give too much, and in a way where it's almost as if you kind of avoid the conflict because it's a little bit uncomfortable for you, or very uncomfortable for you. And with this retrograde, one of the things that's happening is keep in mind that Neptune has been transiting your sign since 2012. It's going to be there since 2025. So some of you Pisces, especially of the earlier born Pisces, you have probably over the last 5-6 years really come into a space where you've got a whole new identity, right? So for some of you, this could be kind of identity crisis energy, and you're trying to figure out how to move from being that avoiding energy into something a little bit more assertive. For the rest of you, I think that the practice is certainly, you know, your practice is showing up in your life. And what I think it's going to show you during this next 5 months, because Neptune will be retrograde until November, is that it is okay to go out and to be assertive and to get what you want and to take your skills and your talents and your love and your creativity and your beauty out into the world and create something amazing with it. And even if you become the star of the show and the center of attention, which is not every Pisces dream, that is equally as okay as well. It is actually the spiritual practice of your life. It is about the stepping up and allowing this clarity during this time of who you are, what you want to do, what you like, what you're passionate about in this relationship, in this situation. Is someone smothering you? Do you need them to back off a little bit? You know, these places where maybe you've been afraid to speak up before, it's going to definitely be the time to do that, especially because we've got influence of Virgo happening this week, as well as some trines and things like that, which make it a wonderful time for you to practice speaking up all week long. And we'll see who you are by the time we arrive at November. I'll be very curious to see what you've learned about yourself there, Pisces. Now, at the end of the week, we have got the sun shifting over into the sign of Cancer, which is beautiful because it's not only a fellow water sign, but it means it's summertime officially. So this happens in your fifth house, which the sun brings light, heat, life, and vitality. And it says, recognize me. I want to be seen. I want to do something here. So for some of you, this is a very romantic, bringing and attracting in some romance to you. I mean, my goodness, you've been figuring out a lot about who you are, your own personal voice. Wouldn't it be nice to attract somebody in who's at that same vibration instead of attracting in the person who just didn't work last time because you guys couldn't vibe right for whatever reason, right? And even if you're coupled up already, this is such a wonderful vibration and such a wonderful energy to say, see me to your partner, right? Maybe you want to flash it up a little bit, put a little something extra, you know, put on some new hair, whatever your situation is, and allow this person to play, have fun with you just a little bit more. Now, other things that I'm definitely seeing as I continue to look at some of the aspects that are happening here is, again, I feel like the place of your expression is highlighted again in terms of sharing a skill or a talent or a passion that you have. And I mean it. Do not be surprised if over the next 5 months, and definitely maybe it kicks off over this next 4 weeks with the sun being here, you start to get a little bit more recognition than you did before, or maybe you're even fully comfortable with, Pisces. Now, there are, of course, those Pisces who are totally happy to be out in the spotlight and all of that good stuff, this is definitely a jam and jazzy time for you as well. So make sure you make time to be social, be out, go do things, share, bring joy into your world. This is a joyful, joyful time. We have shifted into a different season. Take full advantage of it, my beautiful Pisces friends, okay? And don't forget to like, comment, and share this video, and like Maria's page as well for your chance to snag the Hip Chick Tarot deck. Isn't this really cool? Maria has found her own take on the tarot deck, and this is so beautiful, and it's the reason I brought it to you guys. Because just because you think something is different or it's not the traditional way to do something, it's your voice, it's your message. If there's a product out there that you feel like should be out there, create it. So coming up, Maria is not only going to pull a card for you this week to help you, give you something to focus on, but also tell you a little bit about the card in the deck as well. Have a beautiful week, Pisces. I look forward to seeing you next week. Bye.
So the moon. Hello, Pisces. This is a really beautiful, deeply intuitive card. And it depicts a woman wading through these waters, going into the darkness. And she may be afraid, but she has the sun up there, you know, the promise of the sunlight after the moon that's guiding her. So on this path, she encounters this little lobster who stands for primitive emotion. And there's a bat that's about the night and the darkness, the howling wolf. The octopus is about flexibility. The flexibility and agility required to go through this process of deeply knowing yourself, all of yourself, you know, parts of yourself that you might not want to look at. So she goes into these waters and she moves forward, and there's the promise of the sun there on the other side. And she's walking towards that. So she has faith that she can get through times like this. She can get through this and come out on the other side. The card is so intuitive, and, you know, practically speaking, it's about really trusting yourself, really knowing and trusting yourself. So there might be a situation that comes up in life, and you might draw this card for it, and that situation might not really be fully sketched out. You might not have all the information necessary to move forward there. But sometimes you can navigate that through your intuitive sense. So it's a very psychic, very intuitive card, and it's for all you beautiful Pisces people.